Welcome to Animation for All. My name is Nathan Adams. I am your host. This program is presented to you by Shemple Studio.
Hello, everyone. Welcome to this episode of Animation for All. Today is a continuation in part two of the series of modeling a jack-o'-lantern. Once again, we're in Blender 2.63, and on this episode, we're going to carve our jack-o'-lantern. So to begin, we have our pumpkin object that we saved last time. I'm assuming we all saved it. What we'll do is that we're going to, first of all, create a grease pencil layer. And let's get N to bring up our properties. Now, we see grease pencil right here in our properties, and we want to get a new layer. Now, for our drawing settings, right now it shows cursor. We want to change that to surface so that anything that we draw ends up on the surface of this pumpkin object. So, this will be the first thing that we do, and now let's go to grease pencil. We want to use a sketching session. Otherwise, we're going to be creating individual layers, and it's just going to be a lot more of a hassle. So we'll use sketching session, and let's draw. So first, let's get the eyes. Nose. Then we will get a mouth. There we go. And then let's go on the top view and let's just get something so we have a lid cut out here. Right, and just draw that on, pretty easy. And now, when we go around, take a look at that, we have some stuff to draw with here. So now, we're going to take those lines that we just did, let's hit escape, so we're out of our sketching session. And now let's convert them to curves. So we'll say convert, and let's change it to a path. And there we go. So now we have this stuff that we can use to carve our jack-o'-lantern. So this will be our next section, carving the jack-o'-lantern. Alright, now for the section where we actually carve our jack-o'-lantern. You'll see now that we have our curves, everything's ready to go. But if we select our pumpkin, we still have that grease pencil layer we were drawing with. Let's get rid of that. And then this object we're going to turn into a mesh object so that we can merge it with this mesh object. So, we get Alt-C, mesh from curve. And then we shift select this one, control J to join them. And then we'll tab into our edit mode. And you'll see that we have our object with these new edge loops. I'm actually going to get rid of this one by pressing X, vertices, then we'll Alt select that edge loop. And to make our lid, we're going to press V. And now we have an actual lid on our jack-o'-lantern. And we'll just escape, scale that a little bit down. And now Our jack-o'-lantern has a lid. Now we just need to cut out the holes for the eyes, the nose, and the mouth. And in this section, I'm going to be going through how we do the eyes and the nose. I'm only going to do it on one, and then I'm going to pause the recording, and then I'll finish the rest of the results, and then we'll go on to the mouth. Let's go into our edit mode. And we're going to start by deleting the vertices around where we've marked for our eyes. We want to make sure that everything matches up on each side so that we have some symmetry here. It doesn't have to be perfect symmetry because this is an organic object. What we need to do, is make it so that we can use these objects, so that they're relatively similar. Delete our vertices, and now we have a good spot so that we can actually start putting in geometry between the pumpkin object that is existing and our new guidelines. We're going to do the same thing around the nose. Make sure that we have a very clear opening around each of these areas. Delete those vertices. And now we have a good area to work with. Now to work with this, you'll notice that we have all these vertices in the background that we don't want to see while we're working on it. So let's go into our side view by pressing 3 on the numpad, and then we're going to change from our material view to wireframe. That way we can select all these vertices that we want to hide. We can press Control and start circling around all these vertices. And pressing H to hide. Now we're left with the vertices that we just want to work with and a few more surrounding for visual cues. Now we'll start working on what would be termed as the right eye on this. It would be left to us just for our orientation and how we're viewing this. Alright, so we take a few vertices that we'll just call them key vertices. We'll have as our references. Press F, F, F. We'll just pair them up. So we'll take care of all the vertices that are going to be the corners. All right. And we'll also take midpoints. Now, based off of what we have in here, we can then start pairing up our edges. So we have a set of edges right up here. If we control tab to our edge selection mode, 1, 2, 3. So we have 3 edges there, and we always want to go in favor of the existing pumpkin mesh object versus our newly created cuts. And we have 1, 2, 3, 4 right there. So we have 3 edges right here, but we have 4 edges right here. We need them to match up, and as I say, they're in favor of the existing pumpkin object. So I'm going to take one of these edges and actually collapse it by getting X, edge collapse, 1, 2. And I took 2 edges and collapsed them. I just wanted to collapse one. There we go. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Control E brings up our edges menu. And we want to bridge 2 edge loops. didn't quite work out as I wanted it to. But instead of doing that, we'll just go ahead and we'll do it that way. The bridge to edge things works out very well, but it's hit and miss. I haven't quite figured it out as to why it does that. If you can tell me why it does that, I would really appreciate the feedback. So we have two here. One, two, three, four. So we'll take out two edges. X, edge collapse. There we go. Let's try this again. Oops, not edge split. Bridge to edge loops. Okay, that one worked out just fine. We have three there. Three there, so we don't have to worry. Control E. That one didn't work that time, so we're just going to have to take these one at a time, looks like. You can already see there's two edges right there, and we have four right there. So let's take out two. Three here, two, three, four, five, six. So we'll take out three. And there we go. And then down here, I'm actually going to turn on vertex selection. You can see that there's a vertex here, and I want one that's right in this spot, right exactly between these two vertices. X, edge collapse. And that actually lines up these two sets of edges perfectly. Edge, 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 edge. Let's try that bridge just... Okay, that one worked this time. Alright, we need to collapse one of these. Alright, those worked out quite well. Those just actually match up. Oops. And you know what? Control tab. Between these two, J. It's another solution to get those edges to match up. Now, I'm going to pause this so I can finish this work, and then I'll be back in the next segment where we take care of the mouth section. Alright, now to carve our mouth out. This is going to be a bit lengthy, so I'm actually going to take some of these parts and just kind of condense them. So by that I mean that I'll start out with the introductory just carving it out in this area. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So we'll select some of these vertices, delete them out. Those vertices. And then we're going to actually select these two vertices. Say select vertex path. Delete those. That vertex, and then from here we're going to select these two and get Alt-M to merge. just a couple more spots where we need... Oops. Did not want that one. Okay, there we go. We need to just delete this out. Alright, and then... See, one more over each. Delete those vertices. Now, we're going to rotate this edge, pull it up, do the same thing for this, because we're actually going to take a change of direction with these edge loops here. And we're going to press X to delete that edge, but we'll keep the vertices. We'll do the same thing right there. Alright. And then, instead of connecting this vertex to this one, we're actually going to connect it to this one. Press F, W to subdivide. Same thing here. F, W to subdivide. And then we're going to do a couple more things here. So I'll actually just press F to get a new face right there. Same thing over here. And then we're going to connect those to those, then we just need to make sure that this ends up, so we're going to subdivide that, we need to make sure that this vertex right here connects to this one, so press F. Do the same thing on this side, F. And then we need to count how many sides each side we're going to need. We'll subdivide those and then we'll do bridges on them. Once we've corrected our geometry. So we'll do Control Tab Edge. And we just need from here all the way down to here. Alright, so we have 12 edges. So we'll need to take this and subdivide it 11 times to get our 12 edges. W, subdivide, number of cuts, 11. So this one, logically following, would be the same thing. Because what I'm doing is I'm keeping this symmetrical. And yes, we have 12 edges. So, W to subdivide. Repeat the process. 11 cuts. So now we have 12 edges. So now, what I'll end up doing is, I'm going to do a proportional edit right there. And I'm going to move that. Actually, let's not worry about that one. Rotate that a little bit. scale that one way down. All right. And we'll just keep selecting these edges until we get something to match up. Scale that down. Then, once we've gotten all those items into place, we'll go ahead and we'll create a bridge on this. So we almost have these into place, and then, let's see, okay. To be bridged. Let's press Control E, bridge to edge loops. There we go. Do the same over here. And then Control E, bridge to edge loops. Now I'm going to go and clean all the rest of this up, and then I'll see you after this is all cleaned up, okay? Alright, and now for the last portion of this tutorial. I've gone through and I've gone and gotten this mouth all bridged to the mesh for the pumpkin, so now if we go from our wireframe to material, you'll see that now it's all complete. I've also added a couple of edge loops into each of these areas around the eyes, the nose. The mouth I pretty much left alone. If I tab out, and you'll see it's looking pretty, looking alright, but a couple of areas that could be smoothed out. So what we do is we go to our sculpt mode. You can see I have it on smooth brush, which is what we want. And you can press S to get smooth brush, F to resize. So we'll go through and just get a couple of the little rough areas that don't quite look right. Then once we've gotten those areas smoothed out, then we can go on to our next step. And I'm almost done with smoothing this out. All right. There we go. And now we'll go back to our object mode, and we're going to add some depth to this mesh, because right now it's basically all flattened. Yes, we have a 3D object, but you know, when carving a pumpkin, I don't recall it having a paper-thin skin to it. What I recall is that it had some depth to it when carving into it. So let's add a modifier. The modifier we're going to get is Solidify. And what Solidify does is it actually extrudes our mesh data. And if we go to our thickness being 0.1, that gives us what we want. So now we have a nice thickness to our pumpkin, and we can also take a look in our rendered view, see what it looks like now. Not bad. You know what would make it look really cool is putting a lamp inside of there and also making it glow. So, let's put a lamp inside. To do that, we'll press Shift A, Lamp, Point. I'm going to rename this Lamp underscore J-O-L. I'm going to get rid of this lamp up here, pressing X. And this lamp that we just added, we're going to have parented to this pumpkin by shift selecting, control P, and there we go. And this lamp, we're also going to give kind of a yellowish hint to it. So if we go into our point lamp here, which I should also copy that name so that now that all matches. There we go. We're going to take some of the blue off of this so that we have a more yellowish hue. There we go. And then the world view, I'm actually going to take from this grayish purplish color to an almost black color. 0.005 for blue. 0.005 for red. And now, if we do a rendered view, now we're getting a glow coming through the eyes, the nose, and the mouth. But we also have this object that normally the light also shows through a little bit of the flesh of the pumpkin as well. But right now we're not showing that because we don't have any translucency value to this. So what we'll do is we'll add a translucency value. And we'll go into our nodes editor, our materials. With the pumpkin material, we're going to add a couple of mixes here. So right now, we have this mix shader that's mixing these two, a glossy with a diffuse. Now we need to add a translucency. Go to shader, translucent. I'm going to give it kind of a yellowish translucency value. Add a mix shader so that we can combine all these materials together. We're going to put this one on top, this one on bottom. Put them all together for surface. Now if we look at our rendered view, we have this mix, and now it is glowing a lot more. In fact, that glow is too much. So, what I'm going to do is I'm going to up this value to 0.8 so that we get more of this value with these colors in this mix shader versus this value. And now we're getting more of that orange look that we want. So now that we have those items, we can actually say that we have this glowing jack-o'-lantern object. It gives us a much more realistic look. I'm not going totally photorealistic or anything, but it's a lot more believable now. And then I'll just do a couple more things so that we have a ground plane to emanate this off of. So if we go Shift A, Mesh Plane, call this one Ground. Oops, that's the world. We don't want that. We want Ground. I'm going to do the same. Control C by hovering over it. There we go. Ground. Tab. Into our edit mode. Scale that up 16 times. Tab out of edit mode. And then, one last thing I'll do is I'm going to bring the pivot point of this object down to the base of this pumpkin. So to do that, I'm in edit mode now. Alt, right click, Shift S, cursor to selected. Tab out of edit mode. And then we're going to say origin, set origin, and we want it origin to 3D cursor. And then if we go to our location, we want this at 0, 0, 0. And now our pumpkin object is sitting in a place where we can now look at it on a ground plane. So if we now align our view, our camera to our view, align view, align active camera to view, select our camera object, then realign G, Z, Z to zoom out. And now we should be able to see our rendered view, a nice darkness to it. And last thing I want is this ground plane with another material. It's kind of a brownish material. So say new. Ground. Take the blue all the way down. Yes, blue all the way down. There we go. Take the green down fairly far. And then red down fairly far. And there we go. We have a nice nighttime scene with this rendered pumpkin. Obviously, this is just a preview render, but this gives you an idea as to what we're going to have at the very end product. And we'll stop this tutorial for now, and then we will continue on to part 3, where we rig this pumpkin so that it has animated features. So until next time, enjoy!
Thank you for watching Animation for All. This has been a production from Shembol Studio. For more information, go to shembol.blogspot.com, and you can also follow us on Twitter.